bueno, ahora vamos a pasar a un tema bastante diferente. Como les decía en la introducción, un amigo y vecino mío se acaba de comprar un nuevo Jeep Grand Cherokee Laredo. Y bueno, ya van a escuchar sus impresiones. Me pareció un testimonio bastante sincero porque no fue solicitado, no fue pedido por nadie. Simplemente él se ofreció a dar su testimonio sobre este nuevo vehículo y es un testimonio más también de lo que el grupo Chrysler y en este caso particular la marca Jeep está logrando con sus clientes. So now we're going to switch back to English to talk about the new 2014 Jeep Grand Cherokee Laredo.
Now I'm here with my neighbor and friend Juan. I was walking by his house the other day, and then like he also shouts to me like, "I really love my new car." So what is it, Juan?
My car is a brand new 2014 Jeep Cherokee Laredo, and I leased it, and I've got the basic model. But for being a basic model, to me, it has a lot of features you normally wouldn't get, and the car rides very, very nice. It's rear-wheel drive, which I like.
So you didn't get the four-wheel drive, which is like typical from Jeep.
Yeah, I got the just the two-wheel rear-wheel drive, and and what I like about the car, the interior is very friendly to use. I love the touch screen, the Bluetooth, and that's all part of the basic package.
Yeah, even though there's a lot of technology now in these cars, but the big screen and all that.
Yep, the screen itself is very friendly to use. Also, like when you sit in it, you could actually view yourself over the front. Some of the bigger SUVs now are so wide and so large, it's hard to see in front of you.
Yeah, it seems like the manufacturers are going in a reverse trend in those terms, right? Like it used to be like the big exploders and the big things, like you could like almost a truck, really a truck.
Yeah, it felt like the last one, the Explorer felt like a bigger, much bigger truck, almost like the F-150. Where this car feels more like a car, and I'm actually fit into parking spots a lot easier, which is being in a city like Miami, it's real easy to drive and to maneuver.
Yeah, and you also, you got it because you love boats more than cars, right?
Yep, I love boats more than cars, and one of the reasons I got it is it's able to pull my contender, my little Seacraft. So, and I already towed my little Seacraft with it, and you don't hardly feel it. The rear-wheel drive brings it in and out of the ramp with no problem.
So how heavy is your boat? I mean, you have more than one boat, I think,
I have two
right?
boats. The bigger one is about 5,000 pounds, and this is it's capable of carrying that with no problem at all.
Yeah. And do you know what's the towing capacity of the Jeep?
Honestly, they mentioned it to me, and I did not...
It's like 75, I think, right?
I wasn't 100%, but I knew it would be enough to take my boat to the ramp and back, which is really what I use it for, and also tow it. And I use the bigger boat about half the time I use my little one. So I just wanted a car that good for the city and also capable of towing my boat.
So you already have a lot of experience towing boats and all that. Why it's only the rear wheel drive car more than enough than the all wheel drive car?
Because here we're very lucky. We don't have a lot of hills, and we don't really have the ramps.
Snow.
So, for us in South Florida, I think it works well. And the ramps are fairly good shape, so you don't really need. They're not as steep as maybe some areas. So they're built, for enough to be able to use the rear wheel drive and pull it out.
Yeah. And what else? So you have the V6 engine in the Jeep.
The V6, the standard V6. I think it's 3.5 liter. It runs very well and it takes off. It's got a lot of power, and I like it. It's a nice car.
So what about mileage for gas? I mean, how much are you getting?
I think I'm averaging about 17 in the city, which is pretty good.
Yeah.
And I like that. It's very friendly to use. That's what I like about it.
So now in your driveway, you have three cars and you have the newer one. Are you in trouble with your wife?
Trouble with the kids. They always want to borrow the nice car. But they can use it as long as they don't use it as a bumper car like they did the last one.
Yeah, exactly. And you were telling me before you bought this car, your daughter has this used C-Class Mercedes-Benz, which is beautiful, but she doesn't, she's not very happy with it, huh?
No, it's an older luxury car for her, and she doesn't feel as nice as being in the new Jeep. She likes the Jeep much better.
How much pressure is that? That's a tough situation.
It's a tough
because
situation.
Kids like think that everything is free and like it doesn't cost money and like it's just there and you get it and all that.
Exactly. And they for them it's gonna be the keys and fill it up with gas and there they go.
Yeah. It's it's a safe car to drive the C-Class. Actually, I was doing a story about safety with the kids and all that. And they recommend that kind of car specifically for them.
That car has tremendous amount of features in it for the you know, for the value, and I love driving it. See, you know, so that's why I have no problem trading cars. I'll drive whatever car I have available for me.
How is that? That's kind of weird. I mean, we live in Miami, and I can get why you love more boats more than cars. But you never like cars, really?
I just, you know, it's one of those things that, unfortunately, especially in the city, you know, people don't respect your vehicles, and you get a really nice luxury car, and the next thing you know, it's a beat up, and you're disappointed. So. Yeah, I mean, I like being in them, but I like the outdoors a lot better.
Yeah, the boating activity here in Miami, we're like blessed. I mean, we're here in Miami, and then we're like at the end of our quote-unquote winter.
Yeah, exactly, we're blessed. It's gorgeous.
Well, thank you very much for your time, Juan, and I hope you keep enjoying your Jeep. And maybe one day when I have a bigger one, I'll let you try it and see what you upgrade.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
So thank you again to Juan Comendeiro here on his testimony about the new 2014 Jeep Grand Cherokee Laredo, which again, it was completely unsolicited. It was very spontaneous kind of thing, so very, very fun to have him here in the show. Y bueno, no se vayan que cuando regresemos vamos a hablar de toda la información del nuevo Chrysler 200 2015, el modelo que fuimos a probar esta semana a las calles y carreteras de Louisville, Kentucky, un lugar realmente espectacular. Francamente, se los recomiendo cuando tengan la oportunidad de visitar. Muchas actividades por allá, el Kentucky Derby, la fábrica oficial de bates de las grandes ligas de béisbol, así que muchas actividades por allá. Así que no se vayan, esto es Auto 060, yo soy Javier Mota y ya regresamos.
Este programa fue una producción de National Latino Broadcasting.